What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Someone's Listening podcast, and we back with another video. Appreciate all the subscribers that are joining the channel. Thank you guys. I appreciate you guys. Make sure you smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, guys, and share the video. Now, earlier today, I did a video, a short little video, saying that I wanted to talk about the Usher performance and was Usher doing too much. But man, I got to get back on. The Cat Williams, Monique, Shannon Sharp bullshit. Man, what? I know they said that they squashed the beef or something like that, or they gonna have a sit down or a talk or whatever, man. But what the hell happened? I've been so focused on this Usher performance, him zigzagging and grabbing Alicia Keys by the waist and serenading every man's woman out here. I didn't totally miss the BS with Shannon Sharp and Mike Epps. Now, if you guys don't know what's going on, right? So Shannon Sharp, and I'm gonna play the video in a minute, right? We're gonna go into the response with Mike Epps. Said Mike Epps made jokes on Shannon Sharp, saying that, you know, something about Shannon Sharp says that, well, Mike Epps said that he did not contact Shannon Sharp for an interview. This is all based from the Cat Williams interview. Your boy Shannon Sharp is cooking, okay? Your boy Shannon Sharp out here. That Cat Williams interview has been lingering since the beginning of January, boy. It might just blow through the entire 2024. So, Mike Epps said that he never sent a DM to Shannon Sharp to join to do an interview. He also made jokes on Shannon Sharp's sexuality, saying that, you know, saying stuff, making jokes, saying he looked like Madea. He up here talking about he looked like Big Frida. just making jokes about his sexuality and stuff like that. Now, this is where Shannon Sharp, he has another podcast with Ocho Cinco. Hey, Ocho. Hey, girl. How you doing? Anyway, Cat Williams also went off on Ocho Cinco. He also gave Ocho Cinco the smoke. Mike Epps also gave Ocho Cinco that work, saying that, yo, Ocho Cinco, you sitting up here looking like a damn milk dub with no eyebrows. He said, we seen a white dude whoop your ass on camera. I don't know what's up with that. I ain't never seen a video. That's what Mike Epps said, not me. I don't know. He said that's a video. But so he gave the smoke to Milk Dud head ass dude on the right. Now, Milk Dud head ass dude on the right was joining into the fun with the video, acting like he ain't never saw the video with Mike Epps, saying he ain't see it. I don't know what you're talking about. Yada yada yada. You know, playing into that whole thing, right? But Shannon Sharp, hey man, looked like he wasn't playing. Mike Epps was saying, yo, this is all jokes. You know, I'm a comedian, and look. A lot of we talked about a comedian yesterday, right? And see, Cat Williams guy. I'm sorry, Mike Epps also said that he got a comedy special coming out called "I Wanna Sell Out" or "I Will Sell Out." He also made a statement saying, "I will sell out or I want to sell out because being a real N-word ain't making no money." So he's implying, like I said, he's a comedian, he could be joking, but he's implying that, yo, I'm ready to be a sellout. Hey, I'm down. Basically, he's ready to sell the black people out to get a bag. That could be comedy. I don't know. You know how I feel about that, because I did a video on another clown-ass comedian named David Lucas. I believe that was his name, making a video against the whole George Floyd situation, the murder of George Floyd, and making a joke of that, trying to basically pander to the white people. Now, Mike Epps was basically saying that's what the name of his special is going to be coming out pretty soon. Now, this is what Shannon Sharp has said. Shannon Sharp responded. Now, they're saying that they have resolved the issue. Mike Epps really didn't want no smoke with Shannon. He, you know, he's making fun of the muscles, talking about he got them tight-ass shirts on, you know, just going in, right? And so, you know, Cat, and I keep saying Cat Williams, y'all, because Cat Williams, the thing is, Cat Williams brought, well, I think Shannon Sharp brought his name up. He was, brought Mike Epps' name up, but I think that was it. And, you know, Mike Epps, look, Mike Epps just trying to get the shine like everybody else at this point. And you really can't be mad at Mike Epps, right? Because Mike Epps, if your name was mentioned in the Cat Williams whole interview, followed by Monique after that tried to name drop, but Monique really couldn't hit the mark like that because Monique been complaining about people like that for years. The same old ass, tired ass people, she been complaining about that for years, so people really didn't care about that. But when Cat Williams started dropping names, boom, 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 it rocked the internet. So Mike Epps, just like everybody else, is like, yo, you know, he mentioned my name. Maybe I can try to say some jokes on stage to try to get a response from Shannon so I can end up joining the podcast. Let me hit him up so I can join the podcast so I can get on here because my special is about to come out. And let me get on here and start, you know, woo, 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 woo. So, you know, all this, man, look, it's the entertainment business, right, guys? This is the entertainment. So all of this could be staged, right? I wouldn't put it past nobody. This could be just staged because it seemed like whenever someone lately has been joining the podcast of Shannon Sharp, man, they always got something going on. They got something coming out. Cat Williams got his tour coming out. Monique, she's joining Cat Williams' tour. Now, Mike Epps, I guarantee Mike Epps will join the Shay Shay Club Shay Shay podcast because Mike Epps got a Netflix special coming out as well. It's all to generate numbers. Now, I am enjoying the BS because it is hilarious, right? So, but let's get into the video and let's get so we can respond and see what Shannon Sharp says, and we're going to break it down. I got the response right here. Like I said, guys, I'm late on this. But they said they already had discussed and talked about it. They squashed the beef or whatever, so they say. But let's still hear what Shannon Sharp said.
Uh-huh. And this one, I'm going to fire this shot over your head, mofo, and you will know exactly who I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Mention my name again.
Yeah.
And I'm going to put the DMs. And I don't like doing this.
Yeah.
But you're lying. See, and yeah. I don't care about all that other stuff. You can say I'm gay, and you can say I don't care about that. Because yeah. I won't chase a lot. But yeah. I won't let you lie on my name.
Yeah.
Now, you can say all that other stuff. I can deal with that. Mm-hmm. I heard that 1,000 times.
Yes,
just
sir.
Like everybody jumping in the chat, talking about, oh, he don't like number white women.
Right.
I done dated a lot of different races.
Yeah. Hey, listen, you like Skittles, man. You eat every color. Come on, talk to me now.
I don't eat or suck. Yeah.
Hey, yo. Pause, Shannon. Yo, relax. He talking about I don't eat or suck. Hey, yo. You need to put a pause. Somebody should have put a pause on this part of the conversation. You know what I mean? Like, what? Where's the AO? Where's the pause at? I'm sorry, y'all. My bad. I heard that part. I had to, yo, go pause. Hey, yo. But let's go ahead, guys.
Oh, do all that.
You know what I mean? That's why I said Skittles. Okay. Stay. I'm with you.
Oh, hold on. Did he say he look at it? What? What? Oh, man, what's going on out here, Bo? Okay, let's finish.
I look at Ocho. I'm telling you this, and I want somebody to send it to you. And y'all been, I've been seeing it in the chat. Y'all know who I'm talking about.
I don't know who you're talking about, but I'm with you.
Say my name again, and I'm gonna put the I'm gonna release the DM because you're lying.
Yeah.
Now you see how Ocho Cinco's playing into all of this, right? I don't know who you're talking about, yada, yada. Yo, that's all game, right? This is all part of the game. Well, I don't know who you're talking about. I'm new. You know, I don't know what's going on. It's all BS, guys. He know exactly what's happening. He ain't stupid. Stuff like this, guys, we got to call it out because he's playing into that role like he don't know, but he really knows what's going on.
Said I reached out to you to come on Club Shay Shay, and you a mofo lot. Now, I see you.
Yeah.
I'm going to see you. I'm going to see if you about that.
Okay.
I'm going to see if you want to say what you've been saying on trying to get some jokes. because you got mad because Cat Williams did what he did.
Now
when I see you, I'm gonna see if you really about that.
Yeah, and when I see you,
I'm gonna see if him talking all that, when he wearing them tight ass leather pants, trying to be funny, but I'm gonna see if you're about that.
Yeah.
Say my name again.
Facts!
Be like Destiny Child and talk about say my name.
Facts!
I got stuff for you.
Okay, I'm lost, but I'm with you. And whoever you talking about, we go. What? Yeah.
First of all, them saying I'm gay and this and that, it ain't affecting my bottom line.
I'm gay. I've been happy for years.
Hey, man, hold on for a second, guys. Yo, I'm sorry, guys. Yo, pause, okay? Like, pause. Well, hey, y'all just all this flagrant stuff talking about, yeah, I'm gay, I'm happy. Hey, look, it's not wrong with being gay. If you're gay, you're gay. I'm not out. Please, LGBTQ. What's the letters? LGBTQ+ABs. Please don't come back to me. But what I'm saying is, y'all, pause, okay? Pause. But anyway, let's go ahead. That's why I say, hey, Ocho Cinco. Hey, girl. But anyway, let's go.
Now, if it'll start to affect my bottom line, right, then I'm gonna make you put your cards on the table.
Yeah, it ain't gonna
that's
be
what
no
flush
either.
I'm gonna make you put your cards on the table. But that don't bother me. It's that you lied, and you didn't have to. Say your little joke, get your little laugh off, have fun, but just don't lie and say I said something when I didn't. And you know who you are, mofo. Yeah. I'm calling you a mofo. Now, when I see you, boy, I promise you, I'm going to pull up.
Yeah.
I'm going to pull up, and I'm going to see if you bought that. Because I'm about it with you.
Me too. As soon as I get off probation.
Y'all know, I don't, like I said, I stay to myself, Ocho. Anybody tell you, I said it. I said, when people say, man, that's not like Shannon, that's exactly who Shannon was. Mm-hmm. I let my guard down.
Right.
I'm going to see you.
Yeah, I don't know what we talking about. I'm gonna see you too. Let me take my glasses off.
I'm gonna see you.
We both gonna see you. Yeah, mofo.
Now, if you really want me to sing for me, I'll come.
Yeah.
Now, when I'm coming up, look here.
Now, real quick, guys. A lot of people, while watching this, a lot of people were saying, yo, he ain't coming to Cincinnati with all that type of talk. Them boys out there in Cincinnati will run him down. Y'all, Shannon about that, like, y'all. Yeah, y'all, you know, Shannon will run up, okay? Now, I'm not saying that Mike Epps is scared of Shannon, but Shannon will run up, all right? But you know the old saying, if you run up, you will get done up. Well, let's go.
I got special handling. I come with Chippin' and handling, because I'm going to make sure you get it.
Yeah. Make sure you put your address, nigga. Shit, we'll be there.
No, just, hey. And don't come, hey, man, you know, no, because I'm going to tell you what somebody told me one time. What a joke to you is death to somebody else. Don't lie on my name. Say what you want to say about me. I'll wear all that. But don't lie on me.
Yeah.
Hey, all I want to know is how you want to do it, bro. Slide your number. I'll get with you.
Yeah,
slide your number. I'll get with you.
How you
we ain't gotta go. We ain't gotta go no back and forth. We ain't gotta do this. All you gotta do is slide your number, and I get with you.
Yeah. Think we won't pull up.
Now, like I said, first of all, Ocho Cinco ain't put him nowhere. He just adding on to the fuel to the fire. He ain't going to throw no hands. None of these guys is going to throw hands, all right? All these guys are rich celebrities. This is all entertainment. Nobody's going to throw hands. The only way someone will throw hands in this situation is the crews, the entourage. They don't throw hands. But these, man, all three of these guys ain't going to do nothing. They're going to talk they ish. They gonna get together, do a sit down. It's all numbers. It's a numbers game, guys. It's all entertainment. This is all stemming from the Cat Williams interview. Cat Williams blew this whole thing out of the water. He mentioned names, people whose names was mentioned, responding because it's guaranteeing attention. And look, Shannon Sharp, right? There's a lot of celebrities who are mad at the fact that. Cat Williams has this type of drawing power. Now, Shannon Sharp podcast was doing real good before, right? But the fact that Cat Williams opened up and just blew the internet out of the water, a lot of these stand-up comedians are mad because They're seeing the numbers by the numbers that Cat Williams is gaining. His stand-up concerts is freaking sold out because he sat down with Shannon Sharp and started name dropping. But Cat Williams has that type of effect, has that type of drawing power. So Mike Epps, and look, I went to a Mike Epps concert back in the day, man. It was trash. I went to a Mike Epps concert before. It was by God terrible. It was him and Earthquake, my homeboy at the time. Well, we still cool now, but he hit me up and said, "Yo, I got tickets to go see Mike Epps." I literally told him at the time, I said, "Hey, bro, come on, I got you." I said, "Nah, bro, I'm good. I don't want to go see no Mike Epps." But then he was like, "Well, Earthquake gonna be there." I said, "Cool." I only went to the concert just to go see Earthquake. Mike Epps, bro, I can't even remember. He said like maybe one funny joke or whatever, but Earthquake killed him. Anyway, so a lot of these comedians are mad because Cat Williams is bringing this type of attention and he has this type of drawing power. They're not getting this type of numbers off these radio shows. They're not getting this type of money at these comedy venues or whatever. They're not bringing these type of numbers. These numbers, they see like, yo, this dude sat down and he's already at 50-something million within 2 days. So everybody who's involved in that, that's why Monique came on there and jumped on the bandwagon. Because she's like, yo, I've been saying the same thing for years, but I got to get up here and get this clout. You see what I'm saying? But let me know what you guys think, man. Like I said, they said they squashed it now. By the time you see the video, they said they already squashed it. I just wanted to show you guys the response of what Shannon Sharp said. And Ballhead Bozo on the right said he hyping up the set. But let me know what you guys think. It's your boy Slim back with another episode of the Someone's Listening podcast. I will catch you guys on the next one. Let me know in the comments what you guys think. Let me know in the comments, Mike Epps actually admit that he actually said, "Yeah, I DM'd you about being on the show because my name was mentioned." I don't know how we got here though, but let me know what you guys think. I will catch you on the next video. Peace.